Michelle is public enemy number one, and however she tries to make things up, it fails. And Bex orders her to go when the bullies turn up as she helps her at the calf. She applies for a job, but her good mood sours when she has a run-in with Bex and Martin, and Sharon soon finds her drunk in the Vic. She quickly alienates her best friend too. Michelle reaches out to Martin on the anniversary of Mark's death, but he slaps her down. Stacy tries to broker a peace and invites her to dinner, which may stick in Martin's throat. Martin is furious to find Bex busking and orders her back to work. Later though, Martin changes his mind and lets her busk until he spots Shaquille helping her and warns him off. Bex is stunned when Madison apologizes for everything, but how genuine is it? Elsewhere, Lauren annoys Stephen by planning a night out with Whitney, while Kush and Carmel enjoy time together and Stephen plans a fish and chip pop-up shop. Next, we turn our focus on Corey. Peter's on his way to the fertility clinic with Toya when he's arrested over Chloe's claim he assaulted her before Ken was attacked. After being played Simon's voicemail, he's accused of trying to kill his father. But then he's released and races to the clinic to declare Chloe's trying to frame him. Jenny sacks Michelle as wedding planner when she thinks a troubled Johnny is having second thoughts, but is his mind on something else altogether? Robert has a plan to help a jobless Michelle out, and when Steve declares his love and asks her to go to counselling, Robert buries his feelings and encourages her to go. Sally is in bits when she reads her own obituary in the Gazette, then gets a disturbing parcel, and Tim insists she shuts down her social media. She goes to an event at the town hall with Rosie and Sophie, and Tim makes a scene smashing a woman's phone who he suspects is the stalker. Rosie and Sophie are determined to find out who it is and start investigating. Finally, we preview events in Emmerdale. The grim day of Ashley's funeral arrives and Laurel and Harriet struggle, while Gabby blames Bernice for not getting enough time to say goodbye privately. At the graveyard, Arthur reads a poem, but is overcome with emotion and runs off, while Kane consoles Harriet, who feels her service didn't do him justice. Next day, Harriet catches him stashing stolen goods in the church, so he pulls her in for a kiss. Will his distraction technique work? Aaron and Robert are excited to be reunited and head off on a romantic picnic, but they're stunned by some mind-blowing news when they return. Ross realizes he has a golden opportunity to extort money from Robert, who tells Aaron it's a great time to go and visit Liv. Will Ross get his way? Victoria is feeling peaky and wonders if she's pregnant, but when she seeks advice, she unwittingly blows someone else's secret wide open. Meanwhile, Adam finds a test and thinks he's going to be a dad. Will he be left disappointed?